I want to touch briefly on a concept that it has a scary name, the document object model, or the DOM. And we don't need to know the details about it, especially until we get into JavaScript, because what the DOM is essentially is a way of programming an HTML document. That is, it provides the structure to allow JavaScript to change what appears on the page. That is essentially what the DOM is, but it's useful to understand the model in at least the barest terms, because it's also useful for applying CSS to a page and understanding inheritance. So at its base, what the DOM says is that once an HTML page has been parsed, that is understood by a browser, it's stored in a tree-like structure that looks a lot like a familiar structure, like, you know, a genealogical structure. So you have parents and children, and we refer to them as parents and children, and first child and second child. We have siblings. These two TDs are actually siblings. So, for example, here's a TD. Its child is the content of the TD. Its parent is a TR. And its grandparent, its parent's parent, is T-body. And table in this case is sort of, in this, at least in this part of the graph, is kind of the great-great-great-grandmother. You might say that the Eve in this case, if you go for that interpretation, is maybe HTML. Actually, in the DOM, it goes one layer above that, but we'll talk about that later. But all of this breaks down into a model of a tree. So far we've been talking about sort of this is inside of the li element, and it's true that this span element is inside the li element, but it's also the child of the li element. So when we look, for example, at that page, and we've applied things to it, we can see that, to look at another example, that this element within is a, where it says is, somewhere along here, is a child of M, which is a child of P, which is a child of body, which is a child of HTML. And the entire document. So understanding that these as a tree will help you understand why it is that certain properties are inherited from a parent to a child. So for example, if you apply something to this TR, if you don't change it somewhere along the line, it will pass down, and we have kind of what we might consider a trickle-down selection. And we'll talk more about that as we talk about inheritance in CSS.